Hey guys, Kim here. I just wanted to make a quick video. It'll be about 10 minutes to kind of show you guys how the new raising and matching process looks on EXPA. I'll also write this out below here for you guys, but for the ones who want to follow along with this video, here we go. So I kind of want to go through the entire process. Kneeling first is going to be the EP, it's applying to citizen, as well as or talent.aieseconline.org. You know, they go to our website, they look at all of our cool stuff and our pretty pictures, and they watch our video, and then they choose to apply. Right, and so once they apply, if you use a national application, it will go into the OGX space on Podio, and it's OGX applicants, and this is where all the applicants are. So congratulations to all my awesome LCs, all the awesome LCs out there. We've actually gotten 120 applications since I think August when we launched the application. So it's really awesome. Anyways, so let's say that like you interview Brittany Ballard and you think she's cool and a good fit for the program. She, you know, applied for GCDP in this case, and you're like, okay, you are awesome. And she agrees to pay the $150 non-refundable deposit in order to be a part of AIESEC to go abroad through AIESEC. And so she's ready to be raised, right? So what is the first step to being raised? All right, step one is internships.aieseconline.org. And so in this case, you will create a new account, but I already have an account, so I'm just going to log into that, but I actually haven't completed my profile. But don't worry, I won't make you sit through that. But remember how on aieseconline.net, when you create an EP ID, you have to fill out all the information about where you want to go, what have you done, what your experiences are, and what your preferences, etc. It's basically the same. I'll ask you for these questions, so you can fill it out. And so like they'll be able to understand like what kind of internships you want and what you're qualified for, right? So once the student fills out this profile, they are officially registered for internships at aieseconline.org. However, and they could actually start looking at internships and opportunities. However, they can't actually apply to anything yet. Why? Because they actually haven't paid our raise fee, right? And so then you go to EXPA. So EXPA is the website for, that's experience.aieseconline.org, and this is the website for EPs and EP managers, VPs, and internal AIESECers, right? This is where you do your operations. So actually, so since Brittany actually isn't raised, I'm actually using Tuhong's account as an example. Yes, she has a picture of me and I have a picture of her. Let's move on to the better the more important things. But anyways, let's say that I'm raising an EP called Tuhong. So once an EP creates an internship or a profile on internships at aieseconline.org, it will automatically generate a form on people for EXPA. And so you would just like, you can search Tuhong. Anyway, I already searched Tuhong, and so I found her account. And how it used to be where you have a an EP ID, now you have a unique URL right here. This is Tuhong's unique URL, right? So, so you take that unique URL, you go then to AIESEC Online, yay! So just like normal, AIESEC Online, you fill out a new application and billing information, or the EP fills out a new application and billing information, and then you go to under EP management, and you can fill out the stuff. So the only difference is that it used to be the EP ID code, now you put in the EXPA code and you save ID. And when you save ID is when the EP is charged the $150 fee, and so then they're unavailable, yay, woo! However, you have to manually set them unavailable, right? It sounds difficult, but it really isn't. You can probably do this in one sitting. If you and the EP are sitting together, you can do this in one sitting. But then you go back to EXPA, you assign yourself as EP manager as well as myself and Lar. The reason is that we can't see your EPs unless we're assigned to be the EP manager. So because of this, we request that you guys assign Lar and I to our respective EP, depending on the program, for every single EP you raise. And I apologize, it won't take very long, but please remember to assign us, myself to GCDP EPs and Lar to GIP EPs. But anyways, you assign yourself as your EP manager as well as Tuhong. Myself and Lauer, and then you change the program, you mark here. The reason why I can't mark it is because I actually haven't refreshed the page, but once I refresh the page, I'll be able to mark that she's paid, as well as she's interviewed to be an official EP, right? And once I mark these two things, that means now she is available, and she is able to start applying for internships directly on internships.aieseconline.org. And so in terms of where the EPs end, this is where she's ready to go. She's done, right? So you can choose to show her the search tool, choose to show her more things about how to search and match internships, but she is ready to go from her perspective. However, as an EP manager, we used to request that you do one more thing, and you go back to Podio, where the raises and matches link is, and fill and add an exchange participant. So this is for us to be able to track the EPs that we're raising as well as matching, right? Because right now it's very hard for us to track. And so you fill out this information, you put in the unique EP ID code, blah, 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 EP ID link. You fill out this information, when the EP's from, and you put her unavailable. and you save. And so she's ready to go. This is the raising process is now done. So she's gotten internships at AIESEC.org account. You put in the EPID link from EXPA. You put it on AIESEC Online to get her to pay the application fee. You put it on the raising form so that so we can track it. You put in the link there. You've added her yourself as the EP manager, the VP as EP manager, as well as myself or Laura as EP manager here. You put her on available for the payments and interviews, so she's ready to go and she can now start applying for internships. Okay, so step two, how does the matching work? So because right now I'm actually not matched to an internship, neither is Tu Hong. I can't show you guys how the post-match process work on EXPA. But the important things to note is, one, it's actually pretty easy and it's really cool. You can track a lot of cool like post-realization or post-match things, like when the EP is leaving, if they have their insurance, they have their visa, what kind of visa they need, all that stuff is programmed into the system so that it makes delivering the EP experience a lot easier, right, in terms of at least the logistics of it. Other things to notice, eventually the system will have a virtual AN, and so everything will be in the system, but right now it does not show up, and so you need to do a physical AN. What is an AN? That's an acceptance note, right? A student acceptance note and a company acceptance note. When those two are together, that's the binding contract for an EP to officially be formally matched to an internship. And so just like if the acceptance note is then necessary, just, you know, print it out, sign it like you usually do in terms of physical copy, and you should be ready to go. Right, and opportunities also have unique opportunities code. I wonder if I'll be able to see any opportunities from this end right now, but you should also be able to see it. This is a unique opportunities code, so that's what you'll use for the AN. You'll put that the unique EPID code with the unique opportunities code. When I say code, I mean URL, right? And so bleep, bleep, and the two will be matched. And then we request that you go back to Podio and complete this form. And you see here, if match TNID opportunity. So you just click and you just put the unique EP opportunity ID in order to match the unique EP ID. And then tag yourself as EP manager and tag Cindy, because Cindy is the person that charges the EP, the match fee. And so you need to tag Cindy so she knows that the EP is matched. Clear, click here, match. Just these three simple things. And then you'll be able to, Cindy will then be able to let you know to charge them the match fee. You don't do this, maybe Cindy will miss that the EP has been matched, and so you won't get the revenues from it. So make sure you click match, put this on here as well as tag her. I think that's about it. So yeah, I think those are the steps. If you have any questions, please email me at kimq@aieseconline.org or laurap@aieseconline.org. Thank you so much, guys. Good luck matching. Have a great winter. And don't be scared. Like, we will conquer the EXPA system. And I think that, I don't know. Just have a good time with the changes. Bye.